ربنا الله ربنا الله
ليس غير الله ربا للعباد.
ويكأن لم تشرقوا في الكائنات بهدى الإيمان وال
In Abuja, that makes it easy for me to be here and to present my talks. As was announced today, inshallah, the topic of my presentation is going to be the scientific miracles of Quran. Now, what is miracle? Miracle is a feat that transcends the physical law of nature. Miracle is an act beyond the rationale of our thinking. Miracle is impossibilities. So if this is miracle, what is science? Science is reasoning. Science is analysis. Science is quantifying. Science is discarding some theories and allowing new ones to develop. That is how science progresses. So when we juxtapose this position and say Quran and science, what do we mean by that? Are we trying to complement the Quran through science, or are we trying to complement science through the Quran? We're doing neither. Science is a self-repairing enterprise. It grows as time goes on. Reasoning and research allow scientists to discard some few, something that they develop. And that is how science progresses. Discarding some elements, making room for new elements to thrive. And that is science. And therefore, most of the time I give an example of us who live in the Western part of the world. The Westerner is always thinking, is always asking questions, is always reasoning and processing information that comes to mind. So what do we mean by Islam and science? I thought science is modern. How could Quran correlate with science? At the very beginning, Allah in His wisdom, He made some information in the Quran. That information, I'm going to read it out. And I want you to analyze it. See how Allah in His wisdom presented those Quranic verses that have to deal with thinking. You know, when the messenger began his ministry in Mecca, the status quo were attacking him, saying that he's not a prophet at all, and that he is deceived by some spirit that is unseen. They even claimed that he copied the Quran from the ancient books, Torah and the Injil, juxtaposed with the Arabian tradition. That is what they claimed. Well, if that is the case, Allah immediately presented some information, and Allah said, "Qul, tell them, O Muhammad, la inni tama'atul insu wal jin ala an ya'atu bimithli hadzal Qur'an la ya'atuna bimithlihi walau kana ba'dhum li ba'dhin zahira." The whole of mankind and jinn were to come together to write a book like the Quran, they will not be able to do it. Think with me, brother and sister. This verse is not humanic. We don't talk like that. Why would the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam put on such a serious challenge? Mankind and jinn? What if mankind and jinn brought it? That means there will be no Islam. But whosoever presented this verse has to have an in-depth knowledge of all things. That is why Allah, with firmness and surety, mankind and jinn will never be able to do it. The Arabs, they were listening. They speak Arabic. They were listening. Allah is expecting them to bring someone to write a book to supersede the Quran. They didn't do it. Few years towards the end of, the time that the messenger lived in Mecca, Allah sent another verse. Am yaqulu naftara? Do they say he Muhammad forged the Quran? Qul fa'atu bi ashri surin mislihi muftarat. If indeed you say Muhammad wrote the Quran, all right, then bring 10 surah forged like the Quran and bring your witnesses if you're speaking the truth. The Arabs, they were listening, they couldn't do anything. Towards the end in Medina, towards the end of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's, you know, messengership. At the very end, Allah released the third ayah. وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبِ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِّثْلِهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُم مِّن دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Allah said, فَإِن لَّن تَفْعَلُوا وَلَن تَفْعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. If you are in doubt as to the message we've given our apostle, then bring one surah this time, forge like the Quran, and bring your witnesses if you're speaking the truth. Allah said, you can never do it. You will not be able to do it. If that is the case, prepare yourself for a fire whose fuel is man and stone. Clearly, Muhammad couldn't write this information. Impossible. So the Arabs, you know what they did? What they did? وَقَالُوا, and they say, لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ. Don't listen if Muhammad read the Quran, but make some noise in between his recital so that your voice will be up and no one will listen. Man, that is a weak argument. Bring your witnesses. Now you're going to make noise? This is the Lord of the Arab of yesteryears. And today, we have some Orientalists writing books on internet, social media, claiming that Islam or the Quran have nothing to offer mankind in the world that we live in. Now the Quran is a copy from the ancient Arabic text mixed with the Judeo-Christian religion. Now the Messenger Muhammad thought that he's a messenger. Indeed, he's not a messenger. He was deceived by some unseen forces. Matter of fact, he went through epileptic mode and he came out with this rambling jumbo jumble of this Quran. That's what they say.